I am TEAC 4010SL. Hello YouTube, this video is especially made for Ovi Wolf, who requested a video about my TEAC 4010SL. It is also a video in celebration of the anniversary of my first video, which was the Wollensak 5750, posted on December 30th, 2007. Today is December 30th, 2008. So happy anniversary, Wollensak. Video is all about the TEAC 4010SL. This is a two-part video. In part one, which this is, we will look at the outside of the machine and see all of the different functions and also all the accessories that go with the machine. The machine also is a deck and it only plays through a stereo system, so I'm going to pan over to the Marantz stereo system that I have. It's an amplifier, tuner, CD changer, equalizer, dual cassette deck. This comes as a complete unit made by Marantz after Sony had the association with that company. The sound is put out through Sansui speakers. The first thing you'll see is the cover that's located here. It's a plastic cover, just lifts off. It was an additional cost accessory provided by TEAC. In addition, we have a microphone, which costs $25 each. Another feature is this remote control box, which plugs into the back of the machine. There is a dummy plug, which you have to remove to plug that in. And if you lose the dummy plug, you can't run the machine. It also came or was available a sound-on-sound stereo echo unit, which is so complicated I'm not going to explain it. Okay, what we see here is the function controls: stop, fast-forward, reverse playback, forward playback. This is a bidirectional machine, but it is only bidirectional in playback. When you're making a recording, you can only record from this reel to this reel. There is a line input control here. The outer silver knob is for the left and the black inner knob is for the right. A microphone control here and an output control here. There are two separate record buttons which allow you to do sound on sound and other special features or just make four-track mono recordings. Two large VU meters left and right and a red indicator light for when the recording is being used. So the machine is always telling you what it's doing. Up here we see a button for the take tension switch. It's set for 0.5 mil or 1 mil thick tape. The tape that I'm using here is vintage Scotch recording tape from the same time period as this machine. I bought this machine in 1972 with all the accessories. The reels are held in place by these little rubber dugers. I don't know the technical name for them, but you pull them off and they have a hole in them which grips the shaft of the spindle and presses the tape down against the tape table. The capstan is kind of interesting because it is a rough surface capstan. This provides a tremendous amount of grip and accounts for a great deal of the speed accuracy that this machine is well known for. There are four heads in this machine, which we will see later on in episode 2. We'll also see how the motor drives the capstan and how the take-up and how the feed reel and the take-up reel work. It's a four-digit tape counter, an automatic shut-off switch, which just simply turns off the power to the motor. It does not shut the machine completely off. There is a speed switch, 7.5, 3.75, and there is a bias level switch here. So if you have high bias tape, you push it up. If you have high level tape, you push it up, or you push it down for normal. Headphone output and two microphone inputs. There's also a monitor switch here for tape or source. Because this has four heads, there is a playback head located at the very end of the tape path. So when you are recording, you can make echo recordings like I did at the beginning of this video by switching this from source to tape. And you get lots of nice feedback, and you also can get some sound-on-sound effects and other features. The machine also came with a manual, which I still have, and the entire front of the deck is removable for servicing the machine. There's a tape back tensioner here, and then located right here is a sensor post. And what you would do is you put a piece of foil on the outside of the tape. Naturally, TEAC would be happy to sell you a reel of that. And when the foil is on the tape and the tape crosses the post, it closes the connection, which reverses the tape. Now, that obviously won't work in recording. The machine is entirely solenoid controlled. There's no mechanical function whatsoever by the user. And that is pretty much the outside of the machine. Let's take a look at fast forward. It's extremely fast. And then rewind. There are tape lifters under the head cover, which you will see in episode 2, that show you how the machine lifts the tape away from the heads to prevent wear. You can also switch between the multiple functions without going through stop if you want to, although sometimes it can be dangerous to do that. Now, there's nothing on the other side of the tape, but it is running in reverse. And it plays perfectly well backwards as well as forwards. It's a very, very high quality machine. The remote control simply works the forward, and the rewind. The reverse. And of course, in reverse, there's nothing on the tape, so we hear nothing. You don't have to go through stop. Nice remote control unit. The stereo echo unit is very nice. A little complicated to understand, requires a lot of hookups. It comes with its own wires. The microphone is very high quality microphone. And the only thing that I find lacking is it doesn't have a pop screen. At the end of this video, please go to video 2, episode 2 of TEAC 4010SL. And I am going to show you the back of the machine and the inside of the machine, and how it operates. Thank you for watching this video.